delightful variety of children's books out for just in time for the holidays.
Right?
Huh?
What specific holiday?
Any holiday. And I've got a list of them here.
Please.
Guji Guji by Qian Chen.
Really?
Yeah, Guji Guji. Just a minute. Lou?
Yes. This is Lou?
Lou, you're on.
Mr. Soucheray, how are you today?
Good.
Fine. Listen, I was wondering if you might help me with a little something.
All right.
I'm wondering why people feel that they are entitled to lighting displays on private homes.
What?
Yep. Well, I want to know why people think that they're entitled to drive down the street and stop in front of my house and look at my displays.
Well, they're public roadways. The taxpayers pay for them. They have every right in the world to drive by and look at the lights. Is that what you're referring to?
Yeah, exactly. Because I'm finding it very irritating. And, Joe, there are literally hundreds of people that don't belong in my neighborhood. They're probably not from my community, that probably are not paying taxes, that are driving by my house watching my lights that I didn't put up for them at all. I put them up for the kids, my children.
Where do you live?
I live in Maple Grove up... Wait. Now you're going to try to get me to talk about where I live so people come by.
No, I was just... You called me. I was just wondering... So, what is it?
There's an extreme entitlement, I feel. These people come by, it's, you know... I'm here now in front of my house waiting. I haven't had any buses or any limousines come by yet, but those are the ones that I know don't belong here. And I try to keep them moving, keep them along.
You mean you're standing outside now?
Yes, sir.
Well, let me ask you something. Do you have an elaborate display?
Well, I don't know if you call it elaborate. 56,000 lights with reindeer. I've got, it's a top-notch display, in my opinion. But, I've seen bigger. The Minnesota Zoo has a bigger selection.
56,000 lights, and you're surprised that people want to... Why aren't you happy? Why aren't you proud of the fact
that...
I mean, did you have some reasonable expectation that people were going to ignore this?
No, it's not that they would ignore it, but I didn't think that they would be as interested as they are. Or there's this feeling of entitlement. These people come by and take pictures. They stop their buses. A couple of people have tried to give me canned goods, and I don't want canned goods. I just want, this is for my son.
You got lights up. You said you added reindeer,
pal. Well, you put 56,000 lights up with lit reindeer, and you want life to go on as normal?
Mr. Soucheray, this is normal in my life. People shouldn't stop and make it a burn it on me in front of my house, you know, pulling into my driveway with no legitimate business.
Let me ask you something. How many years have you been putting up lights?
This is the fourth year. I started when my son was four, and now he's eight. And I do it for him. He really likes it.
So he comes out in the yard to look at the lights?
Every day. It greets him when he comes home from school. And, he comes out with his friends, and we have them on. But lately, we've shut them off. We're shutting them off when people come by. And they don't pretend to leave, so I stay, and we have a code, we have a signal, and he shuts the lights off inside.
Wait a minute.
Oh, I would love to be there when he...
Wait a minute.
This is it. John, sorry. Sir, we don't allow buses, sir. Sir, please, this is not for your display.
God. Oh, my goodness.
God almighty.
I don't want canned goods, sir. I do not want canned goods.
You could give them to the poor people. Lou?
Yeah, Joe.
Lou?
Yes, sir.
Why don't you take the food? You could take them to your local food shelf.
Why is that my responsibility? Why do they feel entitled to give me the food that I have to bring it down there? I want to do this for my son.
Maybe.
Now, talk more about the shutting off of the lights.
I'll get back to that. I haven't forgotten that. But why don't you consider that? These people are paying you an act of gratitude. What are you calling me for?
Joe, I'm fed up. Okay, I'm really fed up.
Well, then why, you know what? Don't put any lights up.
not. Oh, so because these people are coming by my neighborhood, and you're telling me this, that I need to, I got to stop putting up lights to keep from coming by? I don't think so. I pay taxes here. You know, I pay the assessments. I just had to pay half the assessment on a light pole that some D-horn backed into it just goes on and on. They're not here to pay for it.
Well, then, you know what? You should move to a more remote area and have this display if you intend it only for your own family, and then no one else can see it.
So now I should move. You know?
What do you do for a living?
I'm an engineer.
Mm-hmm. Now, explain this system you have. You turn off the lights?
Yeah, that's right. My son is in the front room. If this gets annoying, you know, where these people keep coming by, about 8 o'clock, limousines start coming by, and they start taking pictures with, you know, all these kids, 16, 17 kids get out of a car and take pictures. So my son sits inside, and we've got a signal. I usually do the siren. And he shuts them down, and we wait till it clears, and we turn them back on.
And your wife goes along with this? She doesn't think you're sending the wrong message to your son?
Joe, my wife passed away 2.5 years now. This was kind of the reason we put this up.
All right.
Was for her.
I didn't know that. I'm sorry.
Well, that's, you wouldn't know.
No, I would not. And you have the one child or more than one?
I have the one son.
One son.
That's right.
Well, you know, short of...
I didn't turn that for you. No.
What?
My son was here. He thought I turned... He wanted me to turn the lights off when I did the alarm there.
What, do you have a big remote switch? I see a big red on-off cartoon button.
Well, it's a panel of switches that I've developed.
Well, being an engineer, of course.
Well, I got to tell you what I think.
Are people angry?
Some people are angry. They're confused. And there again, Joe, it's the entitlement. They feel that they are entitled to look at my house.
Well, you've created an attractive nuisance.
Well, maybe. But that's no reason for entitlement.
Well, what do you honestly expect that people are to anticipate your... I got to tell you here, you sound rather selfish, if you ask me.
Right.
I mean, are people supposed to have anticipated that you want no part of any public engagement, and therefore they're supposed to know somehow they're not supposed to turn down your street? Your expectations are unreasonable.
It seems to me, Joe, and this is why I use the blowhorn and the light switch for the buses and for the limousines, because these people are definitely taking tours down my block.
So what?
I don't want it. It's unwelcome.
Are you in a cul-de-sac or is it a through street?
It's a through street.
Well, for Pete's sake.
Let me ask you this, Joe. What if they found out over there in St. Paul where you lived and they thought, oh, let's go by and take a picture of the mayor of Gumption County here. And they stand in front of your house and take pictures day in and day out.
Won't happen. We don't have any lights.
Ah.
Right.
Yeah.
No, you didn't get him. He doesn't have any lights, sir.
It doesn't matter that you have lights. You wouldn't want it anyways, would you?
Well, but you called with a specific question. You've decorated your house. Have you decorated it for Christmas, or are you one of these holidays people?
No, we're Christian. It's Christmas.
You don't sound very Christian to me, pal. I got news for you. You sound like a complete selfish... you sound like you got a moron chip problem.
You know, I try to do something for my son. I try to do something for his enjoyment, and...
Let me ask you this, then.
I'm insulted.
Okay. Have you... is your son unable to enjoy this?
Well, I tell you what, Joe. He can't play out front because of the traffic. You know, he can't cross to the boulevard because of the traffic. He can't go across the street to his good buddy's house where he can see the lights perfectly, I might add. And he can't go over there because of the traffic.
Yeah. Well, you know what? Your solution is? Here, I got a solution.
Okay.
I got a solution for you.
Okay.
If you did this for your kid, right?
Yes, sir.
All right. And you want only your kid to enjoy it, right?
mostly to enjoy it. I enjoy it as well, so there would be more than just him.
So you and your son, that's all you want to enjoy these lights. 56,000 lights. You've got two options. You called me. You want my options?
Yeah. I would like to know. Well, I asked you a question about entitlement, but you seem to be on their side for entitlement. But, yeah, I'll take your options.
Yeah, well, let me tell you something. You got two options. One, don't put up 56,000 lights. Put up something much more modest that would not attract anyone.
Okay. What's that could do for my son?
Two, go to 176,000 lights and do it in July. Obviously, it's the lighting, and maybe what I'm detecting is you're exercising some engineering proficiency that you have.
Right.
Why don't you do it in July when no one would think to go out looking for lights? You ever think of that?
You know, Joe, I haven't thought of that. And the other thing about this is I wouldn't have to insulate my capacitors to keep these things going because of the heat in the summer. I wouldn't have that cold problem.
Right.
Well, you've given me some options, sir. And I appreciate it, but I just don't think people should be entitled, feel entitled. Your listeners shouldn't feel entitled to look at these lights.
Well, you know what? You haven't told us where you live, you person.
Dummy guy.
You dingbat.
Sure. I tell you, and there's busloads like this one coming up right here. Gonna come up. Yep, there. No, sir. Excuse me, sir. We do not allow viewing, sir. Please, sir.
Lady. All right, I'm gonna go.
Turn those on. We'll just shut them off on you. Oh, sure. And Merry Christmas to you, too.
God almighty.
What a nice way throwing us the finger.
What do you expect? I'll see you. Good luck to you. Lou?
He went to hit the off switch, I think.
Lou? Lou, are you there?
Chasing the bus.
My God.
Oh, the poor
Lou?
Guy.
Lou? What's he doing?
I heard him yelling at the bus.
Hey, Lou? Lou?
There's the kid there?
I don't know.
You don't want to talk
I to sense him. Darkness, don't you? That they turn the lights off.
Maybe they're just hiding, pretending they're not home right
Lou!
Now.
I'm going to call you one more time. Lou! All right.
I hope he didn't get electrocuted or anything.
No, he's probably in hiding. Either that or he ran down the...
I mean, what?
Ran down the street chasing the bus. As they're giving him one
of these.
Well,
there's a disconnect there. The
and
guy...
That's odd.
Well, the guy... This has... people looking at lights has nothing to do with an entitlement mentality.
No, sir. No, sir. Sir. No,
he turns him off.
I don't think he quite has
the spirit. Do you?
Oh, he definitely does not have the spirit.
Laura?
Joe, is this guy for real?
Do you
believe what he's saying?
I wish he was still on the line. We couldn't get him to come back on the line. Apparently, Maple Grove, he wouldn't say what street.
I would be willing to drive out there and see if this guy is for real. I cannot believe that he would do that. I mean, how many times I think of taking my young kids out and, yeah, we drove around to look at lights and that's all a part of it.
Did anybody ever turn him off on you?
No.
No.
And, you know, people play music
outside
their homes, and that's all kind of a part of a little bit of a Christmas tradition.
No, the guy was a party pooper.
Yeah.
I think he's totally lost it. Maybe, oh, boy.
Yeah.
I don't know. I actually feel very sorry for his 8-year-old son.
Yeah, I do too.
You know, that if this guy is for real, you know, that he's raising his son, you know, this way, but I'm beginning to wonder if he's for real.
I hope he isn't, but I don't know a thing about the call, except he called us.
Yeah, well, he called you, and you gave him some great advice, as always.
All right, thank you.
Love you, Joe. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas to you. Gary?
Hey, Joe, how you doing?
Good.
Your show keeps getting better and better and better. That caller up in Maple Grove, I can't wait to find out where he lives and drive up there and check out his place.
Well, I don't know
just
how you
start driving.
Well,
through
I don't know
streets.
How you're going to find. Yeah,
yeah, drive, you'll find it because you'll click it
drive
off.
Drive through the streets, you see 56,000 lights. They'll go off the minute you drive by the guy's so house.
Well, follow the buses. All I can picture is like the Griswolds on Family Vacation or at Christmas. You know.
Oh, unbelievable.
And right. At Halloween, if I find it, I'll take kids trick-or-treating there, just busloads of them.
Oh, I wish I would have asked him about other celebrations.
He's not going to call you back now.
Yeah. All right, thank you.
Thank you.
I wish I would have asked. What's he doing? Exactly. I wish he'd call back.
No, he won't.
What's he do at Halloween when kids ring his doorbell? Chase him away? Call the cops?
Years ago.
Lou?
Mr. Soucheray, hi.
Yes, sir. You're Lou. We talked to you, I think, two Christmases ago.
It was some time ago, I believe, yeah.
And, you were the fellow out in Maple Grove who had the, pardon me, I forget how many lights, hundreds?
56,000 or 56,000?
Yes, sir. That was, I was in Maple Grove. I've since moved.
Oh, okay.
From that location.
But you were angry that people were driving by to look at your lights.
Well, I still am in my new location as well. You know, I mean, that's, you know, you're part of the reason I moved because a lot of people came up to me and my home and was kind of giving me a hard time about my stance of entitlement and kind of pushed me through to make that move.
Where have you moved to?
I'm not going to tell you that, but I'll tell you this.
He's smooth, isn't he, Lou? He's really smooth.
No, I mean, have you remained in the metropolitan area?
Oh, yeah. Yes, I have. I work here in the Twin Cities.
You're
my livelihood is here.
You're an engineer, as I recall.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
And well, you recall as well because we spoke about me putting the scaffolding up and protecting with the 16 mil poly that I put around the front of the house, which tried to deter people from coming.
A barrier.
Do you recall that?
I think that was later on in our...
Vaguely, I do, that you were trying to prevent the public from seeing the lights you had installed.
And it got me so irate about it. And what I did was I did some research, and I actually applied for and was granted a grant to continue this lighting system. Now, it was a kind of a tough nut to crack, but using my son and the youth, I was able to pull it off and have been since getting grants.
What do you mean a grant? A grant of federal, state money? What kind of taxpayer money?
Well, it's a government grant, and then it's if you comply with certain stipulations, then the local government, local states also match that. It's a matching grant.
For what?
This particular one was started through, and it's morphed over the past 2 years here, morphed from a holiday preservation grant.
Yeah.
To preserving Christmas. Something that was started a few years ago when people were talking about holidays and so forth.
Right.
And so this is...
Wait a minute. You mean to tell me you get public money to install your display?
I do, sir. Yeah.
But you're angry that people drive by to see it?
Well, you know, part of the stipulation within the grant is that it's just the requirements are a minimum of 1 hour per day, which I fully comply on all of those.
What, did you have to, be lit 1 hour a day?
The Christmas lights, sir, not me.
I see.
He's smooth, isn't he, Lou?
So from November, the grant issuance is from November 26th through December 26th, minimum of 30 hours.
Right.
That needs to be right. On. And it is. And,
but you still have
it's
your...
Really, it's really a neat deal for me now. I've kind of lightened up a little bit about it. But, you know, I still continue to keep my privacy, although... Not only that grant, but I've petitioned my city, and they've allowed me to use the 100-amp service off the light pole to gather some of that power as well.
Do you understand the hypocrisy of your own remarks? You were a guy who called here and complained about a sense of entitlement in the public because they had the... They wanted to see your lights, and you acted like a complete fool about it, and now you're telling us that you get money to do it, and you're using the city's electricity? You don't understand the hypocrisy there? You don't understand your pig-headedness?
Well, you don't need to go there, okay? You don't need to get insulting.
Huh? Well, yes,
he's
I do.
No, he's right on.
Just a minute. You called here 2 years ago, and you were irate that people were looking at your Christmas lights.
Buses, limos, or whoever.
And you,
I had no right being in my neighborhood. I mean, they were making money. They were profiting off of me.
Well, even to the point where, didn't you have some arrangement with your son to turn the lights off if you saw a limo come by or something?
Yes, we did.
Do you do that now with public money, Mr. Smart Boy?
Well, you know, it's for the neighborhood, and that's what I'm basing this grant off of. So that's how you're justifying taking the cash.
You're going to let the Griswolds come over from two houses down and
the
lights.
What department of the what agency would made you this grant?
Well, like I said, it's through the holiday preservation.
He's not going to tell you. He's too smart.
US.gov. There's a whole list that you can get into of government grants. It's all arranged there. And this happened to be about the holiday lights aspect.
And this is
preservation.
Does it increase, or does it file automatically and they give you the grant for next year?
How much money is it, Lou? You want to tell us that, Lou? How much?
I'm not going to tell you.
Well, you're not going to believe me, and that's part of it. That's part of why we do this as well, because it is kind of unbelievable that this is there, this is available for people, and if people knew, they could get it as well or apply for it.
How much is it, Lou?
It's been $9,000 each year.
You got to be kidding.
So it's an $18,000, and they tap you out. They tap you out after 3 years, but if. You know, with the address change, the first grant there was from the Maple Grove, so now we've changed that. So we're probably eligible for another 2 years.
And are you at least more hospitable and accommodating now that you're sucking the public money?
Oh, he thinks that's...
Huh? Are you a little more charitable now?
Positive Thursday, I guess.
No, we keep it all. I mean, you don't know what it takes to put this on.
No. Okay? Are you more charitable?
It's a lot of hard work and heartache on my part to do this.
No, you don't understand the question, sir. Are you a little more gracious to the people who now flood your neighborhood to see the lights?
Why would I be gracious to these people?
They're paying for them, Lou. That's why.
They're not paying anything.
They're
paying,
and I'm paying for it. I demand to know where you live.
Nobody is paying for it. This is a grant from the government. A grant, not a loan. It's a grant.
Lou, the government doesn't have any money. That money comes from the taxpayers.
No. Well, there's probably some large donations of people that want to see this happen and see this continue. Okay, this preservation of Christmas with the lights. I'm sure there's a lot of people that want to do that.
Yeah, sure, but there's good-hearted people out there that don't complain when people come by to look. You're an ogre. An ogre.
Well, that's your opinion, and I know you're an opinionated guy.
You're not a GLer, are you? You don't listen to the show that much. How did you get alerted to call us? You couldn't be a GLer.
No, you know, you're right. I stopped listening after that one fellow poked me in the chest and told me you heard it on your television show.
I have a radio show, Lou.
Turn it off.
Lou, I have a radio show.
That I shouldn't turn it off.
Radio show, Lou.
I thought myself, my God, you know, these guys are entitled. Mm-hmm. There's so much entitlement going on, and it's continuing. And while you're probably one of the provokers of that, as I can obviously hear in your
voice. Tell me where you live, Lou. Just give me a chance.
I
want to
know.
Tell me where you live now, Lou.
I want to donate.
I want to send you some more money.
Bring you some canned food.
Well, don't you guys, aren't you part of the colony here with the caller ID? I haven't blocked any numbers. You're welcome to find me.
Well, we don't have that.
I'm not going to tell you where it is because
is it lit up right now?
Time of the buses continue to come.
Is it lit up right now, Lou?
It is not. I've got it on a timer. I like to do it a little later when more people aren't around.
Yeah. Well,
you know, that's the funny thing in GL is when you disagree, you're pushed to the head of the class so you can discuss.
Goodbye,
calmly,
Lou. Goodbye, Lou. Know? Goodbye. Yeah. I've had enough. Goodbye.
Whatever.
Merry Christmas. Yeah. Whatever to you, Lou.
Zer.
Loser. That's hard to believe. That's unbelievable.
But here's why. You know, we normally don't go after callers.
I have to in this case.
He was thumbing his nose at
Us. At
yell all of us.
At common sense.
Let's play the final. I have to calm down.
Yeah, you do.
I normally don't get that worked up. But that's just outrageous. I'm going to try to get to the bottom of it. This is the third installment for today of the Christmas light prank calls. And then the... Hey, hit the button.
The Sands is proud to present a wonderful new show, A Man and His Music. The music of Count Basie and his great band... The man is
Joe Soucheray.
How did all these people get in my room? With me, we'll fly away.
Hey, Mr. Mayor.
What?
Well, you alluded to it in the first hour. You got a call on line one.
No.
Well, listen, you opened up this can of worms the other day. I mean, it's the holiday season.
Lou?
Yes, sir, Mr. Soucheray.
What can I do for you?
I don't know. You wanted to talk to me.
No, I did not.
That's what I was told.
No, there's no way I would have wanted to talk to you to upset myself this close to Christmas, Lou.
Well, then someone's having a whole lot of fun with me because I got a text message today, which I was kind of surprised you got my number, but I suppose with technology.
I didn't text you, Lou.
We'll all have that.
Are your lights on now, Lou?
Yes, they are. Well, I've got someplace to be a little later, so I thought I'd start it early. People bustling here with Christmas holidays.
Does that bother you, Lou?
Well, I'm prepared. I've got the... I'm ready. All the sirens and all the things I need to turn the... No. It's fine. Just testing. Go stand still. You still stand out there.
You talking to your son, Lou?
He's collecting some canned goods. Mm-hmm.
You keep that, I bet, for yourself, don't you?
Is that a... Something wrong with that? Problem?
No, it's an accusation, Lou, and I probably am 100% accurate that you're not only complaining about the people who drive by, but when they do and they donate something, you keep it for yourself, don't you?
I do.
Lou, I'm not going to let you upset me today. I got carried away yesterday. I can't find this grant information, by the way.
You know, there's a lot of this happening, Joe. I don't know what your problem is with it.
Lou, my problem is you...
You're probably as entitled as these people driving by thinking that this money should be yours. And it doesn't faze me, of course, that you would have this kind of thought, just like all these people driving by. I'll use people.
Lou, what bothers me is you light up your house with 56,000 lights and then you get angry that people come to see them.
Joe, it's gone beyond anger. I'm not angry about it. Why do you feel entitled to it? You know?
Just a minute. Let me put you on hold, please. Let me put you on hold. Kurt?
This is Kurt. I think we got my neighbor here.
Could you bring up Lou for me, Chris, so Chris and so Lou and Kurt can be on at the same time?
Let's do this right here.
All right. Kurt, go ahead, please. Lou, there's a fellow on the line that thinks that your neighbor.
This is Lou.
Hey, Lou.
Yes, this is Lou.
This is Kurt.
Okay.
I got you. And when we're done, Joe, I'm going to have you put me on hold, and I'll give you his info. This guy's a scammer. He's got Metro Mobility over there. Weekly giving him rides. He doesn't even work. He's on disability.
He's eating all these canned goods.
Doesn't surprise me.
I got to get this guy turned in, Joe.
All right, I'm going to put you on hold, Kurt.
Hey, wait a minute now.
And that hedge trimmer, I want that back, Lou.
Kurt gets upset. He's upset because he sees what I'm doing, and he wants to do it.
Lou, you're taking advantage of everyone.
I'm taking advantage of no one. They are looking at my lights. They are giving freely. Okay, there's no sign that says donate. All right?
I should publicly point you out, but I don't want people coming to my house either, Lou.
Lou, when people donate the food, it's not intended for you. That's enough. I'm not going to get upset today. Kurt.
Oh, now I'm upset.
Kurt,
the neighborhood is going to be upset, too.
Kurt, I'm putting you on hold. Get Kurt's information, Chris.
Okay.
Lou, Merry Christmas to you, and I hope you have a...
If he gives you that address, that's proprietary information.
Yeah. I hope your blackened heart somehow finds joy this Christmas. Okay, Lou?
That's what I
hope for you, Lou. Your blackened heart.
You and these Obamaists want the handout for everything. Take it all. Yeah. Take it all.
Goodbye, Lou. Merry Christmas to you, and thanks a lot for nothing.
Ah.
Yeah. Now, you going to get Kurt's information?
Yeah, I'll get information.
First, let me set up the final installment of the prank. We had three yesterday. I'm not going to let Lou upset me the way he did.
Hey, don't let him upset you. Come on now. 2 days till Christmas, Joe.
Did you get Kurt's info?
Yeah, I did.
Mm-hmm. And now here is the final call, and this is the last we ever heard from this.